mean sequence lifetime. So now I go back to this chart. Stars spend 90% of their lifetime as a mean sequence. So I'm going to compare the mean sequence from age 6 to 65. I'm going to compare the protostar stage from age 0 to 6. So that's kind of like where you're learning to walk, you're learning to talk, you're learning to run. And then at age 6, you are sent off to kindergarten or preschool. Then from then on, you live your life. You go to high school, you go to, you know, all that junior high, high school, college, you go to work, you get married, you have children, you work. Age 65 or maybe age 70, you retire, right? Hopefully, if you're rich, you retire at age 50, all right? That's the main sequence stage, from when you start going to school to when you retire. After you retire, you start getting ready to die. That's the death process of the star. No, you don't get ready to die. Come on, that's too gloomy. You get ready to travel around the world, Europe, Asia, all that, right? During their main sequence, what happens to stars? As you see in this chart, they don't really move much off the main sequence. They start here, they get here. They start here, they end up there. They start here, they end up there. Our sun started here, they end up there. Okay, so basically they go up a little bit, they go up, they go up, they go up, and a little bit to the side. So they get a little bit bigger, a little bit brighter during their main sequence life. Okay, so what's happening to our sun? Our sun is gradually getting bigger and getting brighter, you see? Is this something that you can notice during our lifetime? Can we look at the sun and say, oh, the fact that we have global warming is because 30 years ago, the sun was not as big, as bright. No. This whole process from here to here takes 10 billion years. That's how long our sun will live. So it's not something that you will notice during your course of your lifetime, but during the billions of years, yes. Okay? So our sun is getting bigger and brighter, and it might eventually get hot enough on Earth to make life uncomfortable as the thousands and millions of years go on. The sun will live 10 billion years in the main sequence. So far, it's lived about half of its life. So right now, the sun is experiencing midlife crisis. It wants to buy Corvette, drive around, you know, the top down, all that stuff. It's basically in the middle of its life. And then in a couple billion years, it starts rethinking about retiring. Heavier stars will die much, much sooner. Same pattern. Heavy stars form quicker. Heavy stars die sooner. Lighter stars will live much, much more. The same adage goes true for stars as with humans. Generally speaking, the lighter you are, the less fat you have, all of that stuff, you live longer, right? Well, same thing is true for stars. The heavier they are, they shine really bright. But they consume their energy very quickly, they die very quickly, like Mozart, okay? So stars need to die to live longer. Okay, we already said our sun lives 10 billion years, right, approximately. If a star is 25 solar masses, it will live 3 million years. Oh my gosh, that's long, but it's nothing compared to 10 billion. That star will be... Okay, how long did our sun take to form? 30 million years to form, right? This star already died. It only lived 3 million years. Our sun took 30 million years just to form. You see that? So compared to the sun, if you compare the stars to each other, our sun laughs at this star, you know? Says, what is your lifetime? There's only 3 million. Then 15 million. The half a solar mass star looks at the sun and laughs at the sun. The half a solar mass star hasn't even died yet in the universe. How long has the universe been around? Since the beginning of the Big Bang. How many billion years since the beginning of the Big Bang? Well, that's going to be the last topic of this semester, the Big Bang theory. 13 billion years approximately. That's how the Big Bang happened. 13 billion. So if these guys live 200 billion years, have they even died? No, they're still living. All the very, very light stars, most of them, they're still living. They haven't even died. Their lifetime is so long, the universe has not even been around that long, okay? So we haven't even seen those really light ones die yet, you know?